Hello fellow YouTubers, it's me again, and I've got another Ultraman figure review for you today. And we're going to be looking at something other than a Bandai 6 inch. Instead, we're going to be looking at the Banpresto Ultraman Medius. Ta-da! Now, this is obviously, well, Banpresto's Vino version of Medius. There are other versions, but this is, you know, basic form Medius. And like the other Banpresto figure I've reviewed, the Ultraman Tiga, you know, that guy, it's about 10, 11 inches tall. So it scales up pretty well with the other figures in the line, but not so much with anything else. I mean, here, as you can see, compared to Tiga, Mebius is, you know, just perfect. It looks, you know, they got two characters in a pose, like they're, you know, they're in a standoff, or they're teaming up to fight, you know, someone. It's just cool. So, yeah, they look just perfect together, like, you know, it's like natural. And that's why I want to get some of the other Banpresto Ultraman figures. They don't, and they don't have just Ultras. They have a few Kaiju. They have like Windom, King Joe, Gomera, Bolton. You know, some of those. And so, yeah, Mebius scales up well with other figures. And for those of you who don't have, you know, other Banpresto figures, he scales up excellently with the Bandai Creation large scale figures like this Godzilla. Now, scaling-wise, Mebius is technically a little taller because of the head fin, but otherwise, you know, it looks, body-wise, it looks just perfect, you know, have Mebius, you know, fight the big, bulky Godzilla. And, yeah, it looks just fine, and I like, that's why I like. I like that it scales up with the large-scale toys, you know, from the Bandai Creation line. So it gives them something more, you know, these larger figures, something more than just being really large. They can scale up with these Banpresto figures if you have them. So, you know, allows you to create, you know, some cool fights, you know, with large scale figures instead of just the tiny 6-inch ones. So, yeah. Oop, missed the camera. Yeah, he's not a drunkard like Aces. Okay, now for the figure itself, we're going to go articulation real quick. As you expect, the arms, you know, rotate, so you can kind of have him in his usual pose. You can have him, you know, like a fist, so he can, you know, jab stuff in the gut. Same with this arm, just rotates, not much else. Ankles also can move, you know, just to adjust his footing on, you know, a surface. And the torso also rotates, so there's that. And that's about it. He doesn't have any head articulation, in case you were wondering. He really doesn't need it, though. It'd probably just look a little awkward, have a big seam on his neck. And these figures, they do have decent, you know, posability, but they're not really meant to be, you know, super articulate or really posable. They're just supposed to be kind of a, you know, a display piece almost. But you can use them to have, you know, little, you know, vinyl battles or toy battles or whatever you want to do. But obviously, they're better suited to just being displayed with your other large-scale toys. And in that case, maybe it's, you know, he does really well along with Ultraman Tiga. The only thing I really don't like about this Mebius figure is that the eyes are different, you know, they're a little different. You know, like, see, in the light, they look just perfect, but here, otherwise, they're kind of like a see-through, almost kind of rubberish vinyl. They don't have a texture to them like Tiga's eyes do. I'll give you an example. As you can see, they do have a bit of a texture. I'll have to get up close in a second, but, yeah, he has slightly different eyes. They don't look quite as good as Tiga's eyes, but, still, it looks good. There are other Mebiuses, as I said. There's, like, I think there's Burning Brave, and there's Basic Brave with the sword. I'm not sure. I'd have to double-check, but I do know there's at least a Burning Brave. But, anywho, let us get on to the detail for this figure. You know, I don't need to go to paint job, because you can see the paint job is accurate. It's got, you know, the paint job is accurate, so I don't need to bother with paint job. So let's just go ahead and go to the detail. Detail on Mebius is, you know, good, considering the suit is pretty basic. It really doesn't have quite as many wrinkles and, like, you know, to make it look like a suit as Tiga does. It does look good overall. You know, they got the color timer right and whatnot. Shoes. And the most important part, the Mebius brace, it looks alright. It's actually done a little bit better on the 6-inch figures. But it could have been worse. This is the most disappointing part of the detail. Unfortunately, the Mebius brace, whatever you want to call it. Otherwise, he looks good. You know, for basically, and like, see, these eyes, they don't have a texture. They're just kind of, you know, see-through plastic or rubber, whatever. Whereas Tiga's eyes, they do have a texture to them, kind of a buggy eye texture. And they look like their eyes, you know, are lighting up. Tiga, or Mebius, they look just, you know, kind of bland. You can see right through to the gray there. And something like that, they look good. But otherwise, you know, You know, not, they look like his eyes are off, you know, they're supposed to be lighted. So what you can do? That's a detail for Mebius, pretty basic, but pretty good for what it's worth. He looks like Mebius, that's the important thing. So that's about it for Mebius. He really, I don't have much to say about the figure. It's a big display piece, it's an Ultraman Mebius, and looks cool. As I said, he scales up well with the other, you know, Ben Prestigio Ultraman figures. And he scales up well with your Bandai Creation large-scale figures. So there's not a whole lot negative to say about this, other than maybe, you know, the detail on the Mebius brace. And maybe the, you know, the eyes being a little odd. Other than that, though, it's a great purchase, and definitely recommended for Ultraman fans, or even just Godzilla fans. If you want a big, you know, a big Mebius or big Ultraman in general, just to fight your, you know, your Bandai Creation Godzilla. But basically, for Ultraman fans, it's pretty much a must-get if you're really into collecting Ultraman, because there really aren't a lot of cheap large-scale Ultraman toys. There's really just these. I mean, yeah, you could, you know, shell the extra money for some, you know, bigger, like for X Plus, but what, those are way more expensive. And Tika alone, I got for like $20, so that's a great, you know, the value is great. You're getting a big toy that's, you know, has a nice action pose, and you can display them with the other toys, and they're all in scale with each other. So you really got it's a win-win. You don't got nothing to lose. These toys are great for what they are, and yeah, if you're an Ultraman fan and you're into collecting Ultraman, I'd say it's worth the extra few dollars to pick one of these up. On eBay, they tend to get a little more pricey than just $20, but if you can find a decent deal, especially if it comes with the box or whatever, I say go for it. These are nice display pieces. They make for, you know, a nice change of pace from your basic 6-inch figures. 6-inch figures, sorry, I'm stumbling. And they're just really nice. So again, that's, I'm going to give him a score of 4 out of 5. The only thing lacking is, again, the eyes and the brace being a little off. Other than that, he's a great figure, recommended, and yeah, that's about it. So I'll catch you guys later.